Welcome to the State Archives of North Carolina online tutorial on Bagger, the file authentication tool. You are watching part 2 of a 3-part tutorial. Part 2, Downloading and Installing Bagger, will explain how to set up Bagger on your Windows device. You may skip this video if you already have the tool installed. To bag files before transferring them to the State Archives, you must have Bagger and Java installed on your computer or on an external device, such as an external hard drive or thumb drive. First, download Bagger by going to the SourceForge link provided here. This is the official link to download the Library of Congress Bagger tool. Next, you'll watch a video that takes you through the process of downloading and installing Bagger and configuring Java. Although the video shows a Windows 7 machine, it is also applicable to Vista and XP users. This is the Bagger download page on SourceForge. Ignore the download link at the top of the page. Instead, choose the most recent version of Bagger. Ignore the download link with _src. Instead, download the other zip file. You will have to wait 5 seconds before the file begins downloading. Select Save File and click OK. You may download the file anywhere you like. In this example, we will save and install Bagger to the desktop. Downloading will begin in a new window. Let's skip to the end of the download. Now, the download has finished. We saved the file to the desktop, so let's look for it there. Now, we will show you two ways to open your zip file. First, with Windows Explorer. Right-click on the file. Open with Windows Explorer. A new window will open with your file. Simply drag and drop the file to your desired location, or you could copy and paste it. Now you have your original zip file and the unzipped folder. Next up is how to unzip a file with Winrar. Right-click on the file, open with Winrar Archiver. Select your file and click Extract To. Choose the destination to which you'd like to save Bagger. The unzipped file appears on the desktop. You can close Winrar. Here is our unzipped folder, Bagger 2.1.2. This is what Bagger should look like. Remember, you need to have both Bagger and Java installed on your device. Most people already have Java, but you may want to check that it is installed correctly. Go to your Start menu. Click on Control Panel. If you need to, change the view from Category to Small Icons. Click on Java. Select the tab named Java. Click View. The window that appears will tell you about your Java installation. If nothing is listed, then Java is not installed. If something is listed, write down the Path field. If you do not have Java installed, use either one of these links to download and install Java Runtime Environment. Pause the video here if you need to download and install Java Runtime Environment. Okay, now that you have Java installed, you want to make sure that your computer knows where Java is installed. Note the location where you just installed Java, or the location from the path field that you wrote down a moment ago. Let's navigate to the path in this example. We only want the part of the path before the bin folder. In this example, it's C, Program Files, Java, JRE 6. Find Computer or My Computer on your desktop. Right-click and select Properties. Go to the Advanced System Settings on your Windows 7 computer or the Advanced tab in Windows XP. Make sure you're in the Advanced tab. Click on Environmental Variables. And check that Java Home is present and that its value matches the path you just located. If the values are the same, you're all set. Java is installed properly and configured for Bagger. If you click on Environmental Variables and do not see the Java Home variable, you will need to create it. To do so, click New. Enter Java underscore home as the variable name. The variable value is the path to the Java bin folder. This is the path you just located. In this example, C, Program Files, Java, JRE 6. You will now see the new Java home variable listed. Congratulations! You are now ready to use Bagger. Navigate to the location you just saved Bagger and locate bagger.bat. Double-click bagger.bat to open Bagger. This concludes Part 2, Downloading and Installing Bagger. Continue to Part 3, Creating and Validating a Bag, to learn how to use Bagger.